Hello everyone, in this video we will discuss about the connectionless and connection oriented demultiplexing. Let us discuss connectionless demultiplexing. So in connectionless demultiplexing, so first we create a socket with port 9157. After creating this segment, we need to specify first destination IP address and destination port number in which we want to send a segment. So in transport layer, when the receiving side host received UDP segment, then it check the destination port number in that segment information and direct that UDP segment to the socket with that port number for appropriate application process. So in that, the IP datagram with same destination port number but different source IP address means the different host or different port number will be directed to the same socket at receiving or destination side. Means the transport layer in host A create a segment with port number 9157 and want to send a data to the process with UDP port 6428 over here. This is the another host having a port number 5775. In this case, the transport layer in host A create a segment containing source port, destination port and the data and then pass it to the network layer in host A. In transport layer in host B, examine that destination port number and deliver segment to the socket identified by port 6428. Here, the UDP segment is fully identified by this two-tuple. First, the destination IP address and second, the destination port number. Here, the source port number from host A is used at host B as a return address. A segment pass from host A to host B with source port number 9157 and destination port is 6428. Over here, it check the port number. The port number is appropriate 6428. Yes, it is right. Then pass to the upper layer. Now, similar over here, guess the source port number and destination port number. The source port is 6428 and destination port is 5775. See, same, the source port is 5775 and destination port is 6428. Let us discuss the connection-oriented demultiplexing. In connection-oriented demultiplexing, need four tuple for identify by TCP socket. First tuple is the source IP address, source port number. Destination IP address, destination port number. When a TCP segment arrived from host to receiving side, a receiver use all these four port number value and based on that it direct the segment to the appropriate socket. On the server, host may support many simultaneous TCP socket, means they can handle many TCP socket request. Each socket identify by each own four tuple, so no need to mix up with each other. Web server have different socket for the each client. Let's see the example. The many client connect with the one web server. So web server have different socket for each different connecting client. And it is like persistent HTTP connection because they have same socket per each request. If it use non-persistent HTTP connection, then it is different socket for the each connection. Now, Let's see the example. In this example, the host machine A, server B, and host machine C having IP address A, B, and C respectively, and the web server using HTTP protocol which have port 80. Now, in this host, it create a socket with port 9157. Host C create a socket with port 5775. As well as the host C create another socket with port 9157. It is not mix up with host A because this process is different from this process because the client is different, means host is different. So on this data transfer, we need four tuple. The first is source IP A, source port 9157, destination IP B, and destination port 80. Over here, the host C having two process, process P2 and process P3. The process 2 having 5775 port number and process P3 having 9157 port. Now, over here to transfer data segment, then we need four tuples. First, source IP means here the C, and source port is 5775 for process P2. Destination IP B and port 80. In this case, the source IP is C and port is 9157. Destination IP is B and port is 80. In next video, we will discuss about connectionless protocol UDP. Thank you.